Hello everyone, I hope you all are doing good. So there is only one day left for your exam and students are repeatedly asking me about do's and don'ts and to give the important tips for the exam. And also most commonly the question is, how many questions do we need to attend in the exam and how can we make ourselves productive? So in this video, I'm going to share with you all the real practical aspects based on my experience, and also I will try to share the important tips, do's and don'ts for your exam which you can follow. So without making any delay, let's get started. So today we'll be discussing about the important tips, do's and don'ts, how many questions to attend and how to manage your time. Starting with the important tips, there are general wordings that we listen from everyone, that stop studying one day before the exam, do not carry your books to the exam center, do not involve in the discussion a day before the exam or on the exam day, and don't panic and be calm. So what I personally feel is this is all nonsense, because most of us cannot follow these things during our exam, at least not for me. Though I managed to secure second rank in my SRF, I was myself panic and tensed until I attended the exam, or until I started attempting the questions in the exam. So there is no point in pretending yourself to be calm and cool. What I suggest to you is just accept that you have this is your exam and for which you have worked really hard, and there is always some pressure on you and you have to handle it very carefully. So rest, just go with the flow and start attending the questions, or start attempting the questions, and let your brain show its power. Next, let me talk of do's and don'ts. Okay, so do's and don'ts, just very first and foremost important thing, just carry the original ID proof, a ball pen and a photo. Next, reach the exam center at least 1 hour before the start of the exam. And most importantly, don't miss your breakfast in a hurry. If it's in the morning session, don't miss your breakfast. If it is in the afternoon session, just do your lunch and go. Next, do not be awake overnight for revision. Sleep early and try to wake up early so that your brain cells get active before you reach the exam center. Then try to just discuss and revise with your friends only those things which you have studied until you reach the exam center. And most importantly, try to avoid listening to the new concepts from your friends and only pay attention if there are any direct content that you can digest. Also, do not have any prefixed mindset or the expectation about the level of the paper and the weightage that would be given for different subjects. Just be blank and free-minded, so that you can quickly adapt to the real conditions based on the level of paper. So these are some do's and don'ts that you can follow for your exam. Next, I'll just tell you about the how many questions you can attend. So this is the one of the most common questions that every student will get, including me when I was giving my paper. According to my analysis of previous year question papers, there will be always 10 to 15 questions for which we are completely unaware of. So if this is same for your exam, I would suggest you to attend at least 100 to 110 questions. For example, if you can smoothly attempt 60 to 70 questions in very first go, then I would suggest you to extend your attempts until 100 to 110. So even if you are willing to attend 120 questions, it is completely fine, and it totally depends on your confidence level. So for example, in my JRF exam, I attempted over 113 questions, out of which 94 were correct and around 19 were incorrect. So totally I got 357 marks with 48th rank, and the first ranker of our batch was secured I think 393, and there was a difference of 8 to 10 questions between the first ranker and me. So it totally depends on you whether you will be wanting to attend, or you can attend all the questions or minimum required. And I already told you what are the minimum questions that are required based on the level of paper. So minimum will be 100 to 110 if the paper level is medium to hard, as I discussed with you earlier. Next, it is about how to manage the time and make yourself productive in 2 hours. About this, I will share my personal strategy. If you are feeling comfortable, then you can definitely follow it. So what I did is, in my very first attempt, I targeted only direct questions, memory based questions, and matched the following. So I went from 1 to 120 questions and only targeted these three categories and completely skipped assertion reasoning and statement based questions. I didn't even look at it. In the second attempt, I started looking at assertion and reasoning and statement based questions, and I completed till 120. And in the third and the final attempt, I just cross checked all the questions which I have attended and tried to answer those questions which I have left for marked. So what I would suggest is, see, whenever you are not aware, completely sure about the answer, try the elimination method, which most commonly students will follow. So at least in the exam, if you are not aware that which one is correct, we'll be knowing which one is incorrect. So just by using the elimination method, try to answer them. Don't use it for all the questions. If you are at least 70 to 80% sure or more than 50% sure, then you can use this elimination method. And it completely depends on level of paper, whether you can take the risk or not. Right. So in the third attempt, I cross checked all the questions. By the time I reached the 120 questions in the third attempt, I was only having 1 minute left. So this is how crucial the time will be. So try to spend it very cautiously. That's it. So these were some important tips and tricks that I want to share with you all. Rest, do not worry about the results or the outcome of your performance. Just face the exam with a good smile on your face, since it might be a one-time experience for most of you. All the very best for your exam, and I wish you a best of luck to each one of you. Let your hard work give the fruitful results. Take care and goodbye.